Proctor compaction testing, an overview. The Proctor compaction test provides the basis for quality control testing of compacted fills. The original test method, commonly known as the standard Proctor test, was developed in 1933 for construction processes in use at that time. This test has largely been replaced by a revised method called the modified Proctor test. The modified test uses nearly 5 times the energy to compact the soil as compared to the standard Proctor test. This additional compaction energy accounts for the increased capacity of modern construction equipment. We will be conducting the modified Proctor test on our soil samples. The test is used to determine the relationship between compaction moisture content and dry unit weight. Most often, you compact the soil in the laboratory to obtain the maximum dry unit weight, then require a contractor to achieve some specified percentage of this value in the field. The higher dry unit weight values indicate higher fill quality. Note that there is a certain moisture content, known as the optimum moisture content, that produces the maximum dry unit weight. The Proctor compaction test results consist of approximately 5 data points on a dry unit weight versus moisture content plot. These data points are obtained by preparing samples at 5 different moisture contents, compacting each sample according to the test procedures, and determining the dry unit weight for each sample. Ideally, 1 point should be near optimum moisture content, and 2 points should be above and 2 below optimum. We will attempt to obtain the first data point near optimum moisture content. In a dry soil, we achieve better compaction by first adding water to raise its moisture content to near optimum. This water provides lubrication, softens clay bonds, and reduces surface tension within the soil. However, if the soil is too wet, then there is little or no air left in the voids, and thus it becomes very difficult or impossible to compact. Your data should show this characteristic increase of dry density up to optimum moisture content and decrease of dry density after optimum moisture content. In addition to plotting the dry unit weight versus compaction moisture content, you will also plot a curve corresponding to 100% saturation, zero air voids curve, and a curve corresponding to 80% saturation. These two curves are used as a quality check on your data. Since it is impossible for a soil to be compacted beyond 100% saturation, points lying to the right of the 100% saturation curve must be in error. In addition, most soils achieve optimum moisture content at about 80% saturation, and the right limb of the Proctor curve should be between the 80% and 100% saturation curves and approximately parallel to the 100% curve. Prepare the sample by spreading it out in one of the large trays and sun-drying. Break down the clumps of soil with a mallet or other tool and pass the sample through the number 4 sieve. Discard any gravel. You will need 5 pounds of soil for each compaction test. According to the ASTM standard, you may not reuse the soil that has been previously compacted. Therefore, you will need approximately 25 pounds of soil for the compaction test. Before compacting the first sample, you should attempt to identify the moisture content corresponding to the optimum condition. When the soil is at optimum moisture content, it should be possible to compact a sample of the soil the size of a golf ball using your hand. When this golf ball-sized sample is squeezed between your thumb and forefinger, it should break apart in a brittle fashion. If the sample cannot be formed into a compact ball, it is dry of optimum. If it can be formed into a compact ball, but the ball deforms when squeezed rather than breaking apart, it is wet of optimum. The goal is to have data point distributed from well dry of optimum to wet of optimum, with 1 or 2 points close to optimum. The first sample we will prepare will be at optimum moisture content. We want to know how much water is added to bring the sample to optimum moisture content, so we can prepare the other samples that are dry or wet of optimum. To do this, first fill your spray bottle with water, weigh it and record the weight of the full bottle. Then weigh out 5 pounds of soil into a bowl. Mix the water into the soil using the spray bottle until the sample appears to be at optimum moisture content. Then weigh the bottle and determine how much water was added to the sample. Obtain the combined weight of the Proctor mold and its base. Assemble the Proctor mold onto the base and attach the collar. Remember, do not include the collar in the assembly weight. Now it's time to compact soil into the mold. We want to compact the soil in 5 equal layers, with each layer receiving 25 blows of the hammer. Place some of the prepared soil into the cylindrical steel mold until it is about 1/3 full. Compact the soil by applying 25 blows of the modified Proctor hammer. Be sure to distribute these blows across the top of the soil. Continue this process until 5 layers have been placed and compacted. You may need to adjust the quantity of soil in the layers as you compact to ensure the mold is neither over or underfilled after the last layer is compacted. Remember that you want to have 5 equal layers of compaction. When you have completed compacting the last layer, the compacted soil should be slightly above the joint between the mold and the collar. Carefully remove the collar with a twisting motion. Then use the steel striking tool to trim excess soil from the top of the mold. The top of the soil should now be flush with the top of the mold. Determine the combined weight of the Proctor mold with its base and the soil compacted inside the mold. Remove the soil from the mold using the hydraulic sample extractor. Be sure you have received instructions on the proper use of the sample extractor before attempting to use this device. Break open the soil and obtain a representative sample from the center of the specimen for a moisture content test. After you have determined the moisture content, you will be able to compute the dry unit weight. The entire process is repeated using a new sample of soil at different moisture contents. Determine the approximate moisture content based on the amount of water you added to your initial test. Continue testing new samples at new moisture contents until you have sufficient data points to plot a curve of dry density versus compaction moisture content. Engineers evaluate properties such as shear strength, compressibility, or permeability using compaction. Also, foundation soils are often compacted to improve their engineering properties. This concludes this presentation.